Today, I'm going to show you how I hire 10 times faster using this simple clay automation. This automation can find thousands of potential candidates instantly, in my case, AI automation engineers. It then automatically checks the candidate's fit against your job description with this AI agent here and gives a fit score. And if it's a good fit, it will find their work email using an email waterfall enrichment and also create a personalized outreach email together with an AI personalized video that automatically calls out the candidate's name.
Hi, Henrique. I came across your LinkedIn here and I really liked your profile.
And automatically scrolls through their LinkedIn page while you are pitching your job opening, together with a booking link here for the candidate. And then lastly, it will automatically be sent through email or added to Instantly in my case. I'll give you the entire template for free in the link in the description below and show you how to set it up at the end of this video. But first, let me show you a quick demo and a breakdown of the system here in Clay. Now, very quickly, if you don't know me yet, I'm Ben. I run a custom AI agency where we help businesses adopt AI automation themselves. I also sell ready-made marketing systems like our SEO system, LinkedIn system, and newsletter system. And we also help recruiting agencies with AI automated recruiting systems. And lastly, I also run an accelerator where I try to help other people start their own AI business. So if any of this is interesting to you, you can also check it out in the description below. Now, first of all, if you're not familiar with Clay yet, it's an automation platform, but mostly focused on sales and recruiting use cases. And although it's a bit more costly than a platform like N8N, the advantage is that we have a built-in database with leads and candidates in this case, sort of like a LinkedIn sales navigator. And another advantage is that we have lots of these lead enrichment APIs already built in, like email finders, intent signals, LinkedIn scrapers, and outreach tools. So this is possible to recreate in N8N, but it's just a lot easier and faster to set up these kinds of workflows here in Clay. And sometimes for me, it's just worth the extra cost because it saves me a lot of time. So let me break down how this automation works, show you a quick demo, and then I'll show you how you can import the template yourself. Now, in order to set up an automation like this in Clay, you'd have to open an account, of course. And once you're in your account, you'd have to select here new and open a new workbook. Now, I've already set it up, so I'm just going to show you my example. From there, we can first of all select sources, right, where we can find potential leads or candidates in this case. So you can see that we have the sources like find people, find companies, find jobs, find local businesses, or import from CRM. Then we have tables where we basically can set up the automation workflows that I just showed you. But we also have signals, which can be quite interesting. And signals can basically be trigger signals based on a specific event. For example, a job change, new hire, or job posting. So let's say, for example, we want to track or start an automation as soon as a company posted a new job posting. Then we can set that up with signals. Now, in this case, I want to find candidates. So I just selected find people. And if I click here, this works very much like Sales Navigator or Apollo, if you know it. I can just add in the criteria here for the people I want to find. So in this case, I'm looking for an AI automation engineer. So I've included some job titles here. I've also filtered it on some keywords in the bio, like N8N, make.com, and no code. And then we can click here on preview people. Of course, we can also filter on location, etc. So you can see I have around 3,400 results here. Now, generally, you want to have this filtered down to around a few hundred or a couple of thousand. You don't want to have too many to avoid overspending, but also many of the bad fits will still be filtered out later by our AI agent who checks the profile against our job description. So for now, this is fine. Then you can just click on apply and then you add in the table where we're going to set up the automation. Now, if you're going to clone my template, you will already have this table with the automation set up. And from there, we can then just go here to the right and click on run now. And those 3,400 profiles will then be automatically pushed into the table. So in the table, they will be pushed here. And you'll see that you already have the company name, the first name, the last name, full name, job title, location, company domain, and LinkedIn profile. Now, you can see that Clay sort of looks like a spreadsheet, but you can basically see it like an automation workflow that runs from left to right. So basically, we can add in new columns with actions, either AI actions, API tools or integrations like the email finders, or we can also use it to output information from AI models, for example, here, like the fit score. And we can also set up logic through these columns. So you can just go here on add column and add a new action. Now, again, if you're going to clone the template, you don't have to do this. This will already be set up for you. Now, the first action you see we have set up here is the candidate fit score. And we do this through the Clay agent. And this is basically an internal agent from Clay that already has web research tools and LinkedIn scrapers built in. So you can see that I have a system prompt here as an objective, review the candidate's LinkedIn profile and enrich data to assess their closeness to the provided job description, output a structured sheet that includes score from 0 to 100 of candidate fit, along with supporting evidence for the score. And because this agent can already scrape LinkedIn profiles, I've just added in the variable of the LinkedIn profile, which you can do by a slash and just select the specific column. So in this case, the LinkedIn profile, right? And then the agent will be able to scrape the LinkedIn, look for the data, and define the fit score. Now, of course, in this system prompt, if you want to read it in detail, just clone the template. In this case, I put in my own job description, but that you'd have to change out for yourself. Then you can see the output of the AI agent is the fit score. So in this case, it's a 92 fit score, which is very high, and a fit score evidence. Why is this a good fit, basically? Now, I've then set up a filter in the next steps to only continue when the fit score is higher than 75, which I'll show you in a second how to do. Now, the next step then is to find the email. Now, in Clay, we are doing this here with a waterfall enrichment system. Now, what does that mean? It basically means we have multiple of these email finder APIs or tools integrated into the same system. Why is that? Because many of these email finder tools have their own unique databases. So sometimes an email is available in one, but not in the other. So basically what we're doing with this waterfall enrichment is if it's not available in the first one, it will check the second one to see if it's available in the second one. If it's not available in the second one, it will go to the third one, et cetera, et cetera. So you can see, for example, in this one, it wasn't found in the first tool. So then it used the second tool and it did actually find it. And that's how we make sure that we can find almost all emails from these candidates. Now, there's a second thing we do after each of these email provider tools. We also use a validate email tool to basically check if this is actually a valid email. So you can see after each of these, we have another validate email step. And you can see, for example, on this one, this was invalid. So it looked in the second database and there it actually found a valid email. Now, it's really important in Clay when you're using outside APIs is to use your own API credentials, because if not, Clay is going to charge you through their Clay credits, which can be far more expensive than the actual API cost of these tools. So very important to add in your own API credentials for these tools when you set this up. Now, you most likely won't need these 7 different email finder tools. You can see that this first email finder tool already found 90% of the emails. So if you don't necessarily need all the emails, highly recommend to just do 1 or 2 maybe, because you'll be able to find 90-95% plus emails anyway. And it avoids you overspending on all of these tools. Now, of course, I've also set up a filter there, which I mentioned, to only run this waterfall system or all the next actions if the fit score is higher than 75. So you can see here in run settings, I have a condition, fit score is above 75. Now again, Clay makes this really easy for you because you can basically describe the condition in human language and it will create a filter for you. So I can say only run this if the fit score is above 75. Then you click on generate formula and then it will do it for you. So Clay makes it really easy. Then in the next step, we are generating a personalized outreach email. So you can see we use an OpenAI column here to basically create a personalized outreach message. Now, what I highly recommend when generating personalized outreach messages with AI is to have it heavily templatized and give the AI, the LLM, a lot of guardrails on how to write it and only a small window of personalization, because otherwise it sounds very AI-like. So I pass in some of the previous data here in the prompt, as you can see, like the full name, job title, company name, and the fit score evidence. So it has some things to personalize it with. Then I give it a template and instructions on how to personalize. Again, you can read it in detail if you copy the template. And then it will generate a personalized email here. Hi, Sahar. I came across your profile and liked your experience in AI automation at Ecomas. I recorded a quick video for you because we're currently looking for NA developers to join our company. At Ben AI, we develop custom AI solutions. If you're interested in joining the team at the forefront of AI implementation, I'd love to jump on a call. So just a very quick email. And then, of course, we have our personalized video link. And then here, of course, we have the personalized video outreach, which can be quite powerful. And I have quite some people I know that get really high reply rates. That's worked well for us also for this hiring technique. Sometimes people know, especially because I'm hiring in AI, so they know what's possible. But especially if you're doing this outside of AI, people really believe it's true. And it can be really powerful for reply rates, because if a founder reaches out with a job opening, you know, the chance you're going to reply is a lot higher. So let me just show you a quick demo of the full video.
Hi, Henrique. I came across your LinkedIn here and I really liked your profile. I'm Ben, founder of Ben AI, where we develop AI automation solutions to enterprise businesses. And we're currently looking for automation engineers to join our team. So if you're potentially interested, I would love to jump on a call with you and I hope to see you soon. Bye.
So I think quite powerful. It's not perfect yet, but it works quite well. And the way it works basically is we're using a tool that's called SendSpark. And SenseBark basically allows you to do this really easily, right? So basically the way it works is you record a video and you say in the beginning, hi, watermelon. And basically the system will know that they have to swap out watermelon for a variable, which in this case is name, which will automatically clone your voice and say out the name of your prospect or candidate in this case. Now, important to keep in mind with SenseBark is that in order to get API integration, you need the plus plan, which is $250. Now, if you don't want to pay that amount, there is a workaround, which is using the solo plan. The only downside is you won't be able to completely automate this workflow. So the difference would be is you can just download the clay table with the variables, the name, the email, and the LinkedIn profile. So they can automatically put the scrolling behind your video too. And then you just upload that into SenseBark. Then it will automatically bulk create the personalized AI videos. Then you download all of those links, put them back into the clay table and continue the automation. So it would be a bit more manual, but you would save a lot of cost. So that could be a workaround. Now, in my case, I have the plus plan, so I can have it fully automated here. And again, we already have a native integration in clay with SenseBark, so it's quite easy to set up. So if you clone the template, all you have to do is put in your own API credentials here and then pass in the variables from the table. So the contact name, contact email, and of course the LinkedIn profile as the background URL, which they place automatically in the back. And then lastly, at the end of this workflow, you can of course send it through email. Now, if you don't have lots of potential candidates or a huge database here, you can also just use a Gmail action. In this case, I used Instantly to be a bit safer. Instantly is an outreach tool, right, that where you can bulk send emails. So I just push this to an Instantly campaign here. You can see I just push it to a new campaign and I pass over the work email, of course, the first name, the last name, the company name, then the personalized outreach email as a variable and the video link as a variable. And then that gets all pushed to Instantly, where I've set up a simple email here where I have the personalization and the video link built in with thanks Ben, founder of OpenAI. So if I show a preview here and select the lead, you can see that it would look like this, and send a test email, you can see that the actual email would look like this. And then here we have the link with the personalized video and a booking link. Now, lastly, let me show you how to import the template quickly. So basically, if you go in the link in the description below, you will get a link once you've downloaded the free template. Once you click that link, you will arrive in a view like this. Then you click here on create table. If you haven't made an account on Clay yet, it will ask you to create an account first. But once you click there, you'll arrive on a screen like this. And basically, you'll see you have already all the columns set up for you. Now, the first thing you will have to do is upgrade your plan, because in order to do this and use this, you do need the starter plan, because you do need some clay credits. So you do need to pay $149, which, depending on the use case for you, might make sense for you or not. But you do need the starter plan. Then second, what you need to do is go here in the candidate fit score, click on edit column. Right, and important here to add in your own API credentials. So in this case, you can see that in this agent, it says Clay managed OpenAI account. Now this means Clay is going to charge you through Clay credits, which is going to be a lot more expensive. So you want to add in your own OpenAI API key here, right? And you want to do that also for the other OpenAI column here, right? You want to change this also. And then of course, also here in the work email finder, you want to do the same, right? So here in edit column for find work email, again, you most likely won't need all seven. And I'm not sure which one is the cheapest if you use an API credit. So you can check that, maybe which one makes most sense to keep, or if you want them all. But important here is to go here in the full configuration and again, change this to the specific API key that you are going to use. Of course, you can use the Clay credits too, if you're happy to pay for this, but it's going to be a little bit more expensive. Then lastly, of course, you need to go into the SenseBark too and add in your own credentials. So with SenseBark, it basically works like that. You create an account, you create a video for a campaign and you say watermelon, right? Then you create a dynamic video out of that inside of a campaign. Then you add your SenseBark account with your API key, and then you can run the specific campaign, add in, which you can see all the specific variables which are already here, and then it will automatically generate this personalized video. And then lastly, you can, of course, connect it to your outreach tool like Instantly or any other you might have. And of course, you can connect it here too. So those are sort of the step-by-step things you have to do. Anyway, hopefully this was helpful. Thank you so much for watching. I've also just posted a video on a very extensive recruiting system we built over months. So if you're maybe in recruiting, that could be an interesting video to check out, which I'll make sure to link up here too. Thank you so much.